The cockatoo and the human child, two very different species far from each other on the evolutionary tree. Yet they have more in common than one might expect. A group of scientists believe studying them both may offer new insight into the mind and intelligence. Many animals stop playing when they reach adulthood, but the goffin's cockatoo maintains its mischievous antics and a tendency to explore with objects, in ways that are certainly reminiscent of the play of human children. The goffin's problem-solving abilities are also similar to that of young children. Is this a coincidence, or has evolution come to a similar answer across both time and space? The goffin's cockatoo, also known as the Tanimbar corella, is endemic to the islands of Tanimbar in the Maluku province of Indonesia. This bird is a clever forager able to take advantage of many foods in its habitat. On the other side of the world, a flock of goffins can be found far from their ancestral home in an aviary in Austria. Here, Professor Elise Ausberg of the Messerli Institute in Vienna studies the behaviour of these birds. And her findings have revealed incredible new information about avian cognition, including a remarkable discovery.
The whole story about the tuyus and the cockatoos was observed quite accidentally. We had a student and she was collecting focal data from outside the aviary, and she saw that a bird called Figaro was playing with the stone pebble, and he would try to dip the pebble into water and then bring it somewhere else, hide it and retrieve it, and he was really into it. But at some point, he inserted the pebble through the aviary grid where it came to fell outside his reach. And he tried to go through the grid with his foot, but he just couldn't reach the pebble. And what he did was,
he went away and he came back with a little stick and seemingly tried to fish for it. When we heard this, we got very excited and we put a nut exactly where the stone had been, outside the aviary.
But we hadn't calculated that a nut is, of course, much more precious than a stone pebble. And Figaro was such not motivated to go away again and leave that nut alone to fetch a stick. So instead, what he did was much more surprising. He would bite into the aviary beam and bite a little splinter until he had reached the appropriate length, bit the splinter out, modified it, and used that to rake the nut into his reach.
These birds are very flexible in their tool use behaviour. They are good at judging how long of a stick they might need, and they can make the same tool out of different materials. Making, using and innovating tools is a challenging behaviour, even for children. Professor Sarah Beck from the University of Birmingham has discovered that children as late as 8 years of age have trouble innovating a simple hook tool.
Humans are expert tool users, and we know that from a very young age, often before their second birthday, children are also very confident at using tools, often things like spoons, but also more opaque technology like remote controls. One of the things that's really surprising in the work that I've done with my research group is finding that actually, even though children are good at using tools, they find it very difficult to innovate tools, to create new tools and solve new problems, possibly until they're about the age of 8 years of age. In the hook making task, we knew that children found it very easy if we gave them a hook tool to solve this task. They understood what was the right kind of tool and recognised it and then were able to use it. But what they weren't good at was taking a straight pipe cleaner and bending it into a hook, so innovating their own tool. This is surprising because in other species, and especially some of the large-brained birds, these species have been able to solve the same kind of task, which is interesting because actually, often these birds can perform at a similar age to 2 to 4 year old children. One of the things that we're interested in doing is trying to make much closer comparisons between the human children and the birds, in particular the cockatoos, because that allows us to understand what are the processes involved in solving these puzzles, in being able to innovate and to use tools in this sophisticated way. And also, how has this evolved? Where do these abilities come from?
The cockatoos are unusually good animal innovators. In this series of puzzle boxes, which scientists have called the innovation arena, the birds have to innovate solutions to a wide variety of technical problems. And it's not just the goffins living in this lab in Austria. At a partner research station in Tannenbach, scientists have found their wild counterparts to be just as clever and capable at solving these problems. There's still much to discover about the innovative abilities of children and cockatoos. By learning about one species, we may come to better understand the other.
Ha ha ha.